Motion and Todoist are some of the biggest to-do list applications on the market right now, and you're probably working out which one to go for, one being a little bit more expensive and the other being less expensive, but which one is right for you? Today we're going to break down the pricing, we're going to break down everything you need to know about each apps, like the pros and cons, as well as all of the features to help you understand. We're going to do a side-by-side review to establish what features are important to you and give you a verdict near the end of the video. Hello there, my name is Francesco. Welcome to Toolfinder. If you're new, subscribe. And if you're interested in joining Toolfinder, which is a site for finding insights and reviews on tools and software, you can find it linked below. You can join for free. And naturally, if you want a deal on any of the applications mentioned, like Todoist and Motion, you can find them in the description below or up here. I'm not really sure where it is. So let's first establish what both of these applications do. If you know this already, you can skip ahead and there will be timestamps throughout this video. So what does Todoist do and who's it best for? Very simply, Todoist is a more basic task management application. It more recently has added calendar abilities and has some light project management functions. It's pretty much used by individuals ranging from Sally down the road all the way to Bob in finance, as well as small teams to manage their daily productivity. Now, Motion is slightly different because it manages your tasks in calendar, but it has some more powerful project management abilities. It is used by busy professionals, freelancers, and those that want to take productivity administration out of their work because of the AI features. So I can see Sarah as a freelancer using it, all the way to a small to medium-sized team using it for project management. So those are the core differences between the applications. So now let's look at pricing, because this is important to establish, as well as what devices they're available on. So let's take a look at pricing before we move on. Both of these are vastly different, with Todoist having a free plan, which Motion does not. Todoist has a premium pricing of $4 per user per month, which works out to be $48 per year, whereas Motion has a pricing of $19 per user per month billed annually, which naturally is quite a lot of difference per year, almost 3 to 4 times the pricing. Now, in terms of a team pricing, Todoist does have that option. With $6 per user per month, it naturally is compared to Motion's, which is $12 per user per month, which is almost twice the pricing. Now, naturally, both of these applications have varied pricing and varied features. So let's take a look at some of the core features and compare which one is most suited to you. Now let's start with tasks and calendar, which are the primary experiences for individual users. Now Todoist has a really clean interface and so does Motion, but you'll notice that Todoist has a range of different views for being able to express the today and upcoming areas which you'll spend most of your time as an individual on. Now Motion does not have this option. There's a few different views where you can access week and day view. In terms of display options, Motion's views are not as optional as Todoist views. You get to see your tasks on the right hand side and everything's much more focused towards time blocking because events are much more popular inside of Motion than they are in Todoist. And that leads me perfectly onto the calendar integrations. Inside of Motion, you can connect 3 calendar options, iCloud Calendar, Outlook, and also Google Calendar, which makes adding calendars and seeing a range of them really easy in the app. Whereas inside of Todoist, you only currently get Google Calendar, and that's in the upcoming area. The today area is set to release the calendar. I'm currently in the beta. But as you can see, the applications are naturally much more focused on the calendar views, and bringing in more calendar means more powerful options. But there's another element to the calendar abilities in this view. Inside of Motion, you can create an event and even start a video conference from there. Whereas inside of Todoist, you can't quite do that. The limit you have is task management, which is something that you'll notice inside of the application in terms of its functionality. Now, in terms of actual tasks, each task in Todoist allows you to organize it in a project and a section. You can add a description, subtasks, and even an assignee and due date. There's even more recently a duration function, which will allow you to see when you started your task and when you aim to finish it, which is really helpful. Whereas if you look inside of Motion, whilst you have project and workspace areas, you also have status, priority, which is slightly different to Todoist, with much more, I would say, real life priorities like high, medium, low, and ASAP, as well as duration, chunking, start date, deadline, and hard deadline if you're using the auto scheduling function. There's also a way that you can actually schedule it per working hours, which is great if your availability changes or you do nights or a certain shift or type of schedule, and you can edit that inside of Motion settings. You can also add labels and, more recently, a custom field area, which helps you in the projects area to break things down much more in detail. For example, you can add labels in Todoist, but it's probably not as extensive as inside of Motion's abilities because you can add things like dates, URLs, multiple people, and more. Now, each of these applications have commenting and activity areas for adding more detail. And the main or core difference is the fact that the task management has AI built in, which is just auto-scheduling through an algorithm, which will reorganize your task for you, whereas Todoist has none of this. Motion also has an ability to use a start task now function, which pins your task in a top right hand corner for you to play it and start working on it. Now, everything inside of Todoist is obviously much more static. It's organized by you, whereas in Motion, it's very much dynamic, which means you'll see your tasks move around a lot. And you can also resolve them, which you can do in Todoist with Overdue, but resolve them using the algorithm to then produce a better result. Chunking is also a really helpful feature that you get inside of Motion, which will allow you to break down your tasks into three separate chunks, two or more, to be able to organize them more effectively. So in terms of tasks and calendar, there's much more functionality when it comes to Motion. There's even smaller abilities like starting your tasks later, stopping them earlier, blocking certain hours out, which is a small feature, but very helpful for those that want to be able to auto-schedule and coordinate them a lot more better. So in terms of settings, you can go and break down what you'd like to see in terms of calendar and auto-scheduling functions inside of the application. And each of the subtasks in Todoist can be assigned to somebody or scheduled to another person, which is very helpful. But all in all, the tasks and calendar abilities are much more pungent inside of Motion. Now, moving on to collaborative functions, each of these applications have some form of project management. In terms of Motion, the project management abilities are pretty extensive. There's List, Kanban, and Gantt. Now, you do inside of Todoist get List, Kanban, and Calendar, which allows you to help coordinate that work. But the Gantt view is pretty decent inside of Motion. It's a nice, more professional view that will allow you and your team to coordinate what you're working on next. And there's workspaces as well to break tasks down. Now, Todoist did introduce team workspaces, which will allow you to break your tasks and projects down into different areas and naturally browse all of your projects that you're ranging from. And this is something that you get automatically inside of Motion. But there's a feature that's slightly different. You know that auto scheduling I mentioned earlier that uses AI to work out what you need to do for the day? Well, that same system works inside of the team scheduling abilities, which means you can naturally have everyone else on a shift and schedule, but it also will organize that to people's workload management, which is great for allowing teams to reduce certain workloads and also improve how you're using your time as well. Now, the range of views is really nice and adding a project is really good, but you also have something called workflow templates inside of Motion, which allow you to break down some of your projects into stages and add a lot more detail. Things like who it's blocked by and also other attributes will help you to add more variables and details to the projects you're working on. And that's something that you won't get inside of Todoist, right now at least. In terms of additional abilities that both of these applications have, Todoist have something called Karma, which for individuals will help you to see how productive you've been across a week. Now, also, I would say that Todoist have a really powerful mobile application, which is great for capturing stuff across a day. There is also an AI assistant, which is very basic and allows you to suggest tasks, make them more actionable, and break them down as well, which, in comparison with Motion's abilities, isn't really fantastic, but does the job quite well. The fact that they've got a really good infrastructure is really helpful inside Todoist, and being able to time block is really easy as well. So those who want to be able to use a calendar and task together will find this application really good. Whereas in Motion, there are additional abilities that Todoist don't have, like booking links. You can create a one-time booking link, dragging some time slots that are more suitable for you, or you can actually create a copy link that will help to share with other people. And the editing abilities in that is great. Things like buffer time, duration, where you want the location of the meeting to be connected to a video conferencing tool like Zoom, Meet, or maybe in a phone number is all pre-built inside of the booking links, which will help you to save time booking a meeting. This also reduces context switching because some people obviously use apps like cal.com or Calendly. Both we've got reviews on if you're interested in exploring them, but obviously saves you that element that you don't get inside of Todoist. So now we've looked at both of these applications. We've looked at the tasks, the calendar, the projects, and the AI abilities. But which is the pros and cons to this? This is obviously an important section to work out which one is good based on the comparison. So Motion's pros are definitely the artificial intelligence. That goes as an algorithm that will help you to organize your task, reducing productivity administration. And it does come with some pretty extensive project management abilities that are much better than we see in Todoist. Although the cons are, the learning curve does take slightly longer with this application. In terms of more features, there are more learnings to do. And the price of the application is probably something to note. It is almost 3 to 4 times the cost of Todoist. Now, looking at Todoist Pros, it's easy to use. It's fairly customizable and it has a really good platform that's recently added calendar and team workspaces. So the development cycle is good. This application is really well built and has over a 17-year history on the market, which again is another really credible thing. The cons are that naturally there are some limits to the free plan, like not accessing reminders, which is a bit of a shame, and the calendar view is definitely by the premium. But all in all, if you compare it to Motion, it actually has a free plan, which is quite helpful. Not shots fired, but obviously that is a different variable if your budget is much lower. So let's take some time to work out which one's right for you, which one is better suited, and which one is worth your money and your time. So if you look at Motion, I would say you'd have to break it down into two parts, budget and administration. Now, if you're looking at budget, I would say Todoist is better. In terms of value for money, what Todoist have put together in their premium pricing for $48 a year is so valuable. It is really good value because you've got calendar, at least you've got Google Calendar, some project management abilities, and pretty much all of the features you'd get in basic task management. You won't get some powerful AI and some other abilities, but that's something to note. I think budget, if that's a concern of yours, then Todoist is a definite option, or at least some Todoist alternatives to consider. And if Motion is, or you're not worried about budget, then Motion is great for you because it's got all the features, more powerful features than Todoist, but comes at a slightly more expensive pricing. And if that's not a problem for you, then you're going to get more powerful task management in Motion. Now, the other thing is administration. Todoist requires a lot of administration. It's about you organizing your tasks for the day ahead and even the weeks ahead. Whereas with Motion, it takes that workload out of it, especially with teams and for individuals that have lots of meetings and that want to be able to just throw tasks in there and for it to automatically populate the experience. That is something to note. If you spend maybe an hour a day administrating your work, how much is that hour worth to you? And can you correlate it to the monthly spend on Motion? That's something to seriously consider. Both of these applications are really good, but what I would say is I see people typically going for Todoist when they want basic task management and Motion when they want advanced task management. So hopefully this helped you find the best one for you. Both of these applications are really similar, but we hope it established a difference between them and we help you to strive with the application you've gone with. If you're new here, subscribe. And if you want to check out another video, there will be some popping up in a moment. And you can check out Toolfinder and join it to get reviews and insights forever.